light has risen in the darkness for the upright of heart. The Lord is generous, merciful, and just. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we ask Almighty God, that the nativity of the Savior of the world, made known by the guidance of a star, may be revealed ever more fully to our minds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one who testifies, and the Spirit is truth. So there are three who testify, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and the three are of one accord. If we accept human testimony, the testimony of God is surely greater. Now the testimony of God is this, that he has testified on behalf of his Son. Whoever believes in the Son of God has this testimony within himself. Whoever does not believe God has made him a liar by not believing the testimony God has given about his Son. And this is the testimony. God gave us eternal life, and that this life is in the Son. Whoever possesses the Son has life. Whoever does not possess the Son of God does not have life. I write these things to you so that you may know that
When he saw Jesus, he fell prostrate, pleaded with him, and said, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." Jesus stretched out his hand, touched him, and said, "I do will it, be made clean." And the leprosy left him immediately. Then he ordered him not to tell anyone, but, "Go, show yourself to the priest, and offer yourself for cleansing for what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The report about him spread all the more, and great crowds assembled to listen to him and to be cured of their ailments. But he would withdraw to deserted places to pray. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Rather simple lesson story for us today from this gospel. Now, our first reading does touch on some very deep, or however you want to describe it, lofty, complex theological topics, talking about the spirit, the water, and the blood. However, the little bit of prudence I do have tells me we're not going to jump into all of that quite on a Friday morning at 6:45. But rather, looking at the gospel, and the simple lesson which it has for us this morning, I want to give to you this man with leprosy and the supreme humility that is found in him and in his request. Now see, the first thing that stands out to me is how he asks for the Lord to heal him. He says, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." How often do we approach the Lord with, I might say this gently, but demands? We say, "God, I need you to do something." Or, "God, if you want me to blank, then you're going to have to blank." "God, I need a sign. God, I need this." This man here simply says, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." His focus is the will of the Lord and not his own will. He's made it clear that, of course, he would love to be cured, but he's not trying to impose that will on the Lord. There is a humble receptivity to it. And of course, to add to this, he is making the statement in a prostrate pose. He fell before the Lord, prostrated him on the ground, and then made this statement. And then, what also came to my mind is, well, how did he know who Jesus was in the first place? But perhaps this is one of the most surprising parts of this little story. And of course, the miracle itself is the hinge point, the critical focus. But how this man knew that this man in front of him, the Lord, was indeed the chosen one, the Messiah, the Christ, it's not said in the Gospels. This is very early in the ministry of Jesus. His popularity is not out there yet. And of course, 2,000 years ago, they don't have phones, pictures, ways to quickly spread information. All they can say is, "Well, there's a man from Galilee going around doing stuff." And I have a picture of him. Sometimes they might not even have a name. And this is the 5th chapter of Luke. So Jesus has been baptized in the Jordan, but we've not yet fully entered into that very public ministry. He has begun his public ministry, yes, but he's not well known yet. This man with leprosy is to be for us a model of how to approach the Lord in prayer, how to have a spirit of humility, how to make a request to him. The Lord receives his prayer with kindness, gentleness, and of course, with a positive, affirmative answer. He provides the healing that he seeks. Let's hold this man in our prayers. Let's ask for the Lord to come to heal the parts of our life, but with a spirit of humility. We cannot impose anything on our Lord. We cannot demand anything from him. But rather, in this spirit of faith and humility, we must ask him that his will be done.
For those preparing for baptism, for those struggling with faith, for the inspiration of the Spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who bear witness in court, for judges and juries, for unity in the search of truth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who betray the truth, for those who bear false witness, for repentance and return to the testimony of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, for those whose spirits are troubled, for hope in the life of the Son, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, especially Joe Mendenhall, and for those who died without hope, they may share in the life-giving testimony of the Son, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we continue to pray for an increase of vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, let us offer this our diocesan prayer to St. Joseph. Go to St. Joseph,
as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families, help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, raise Jesus the high priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren
hear and save us from all of Jesus.
Just as you and Mary could save Joseph for your hearts.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to grant us the faith and humility of the man with leprosy whom your Son cured. We present all of these prayers at your feet, and we ask that you hear and answer them according to your will. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed God, I pray for you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the divine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for under the rule of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, he made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim the death of the Lord
and profess your resurrection
until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace, Ryan.
Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my house, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
By this, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him.
Please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Body.
touch us through our partaking of your sacrament, work, we pray, the effects of its power in our hearts, that we may be made fit to receive your gift through this very gift itself, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.